G'day, welcome back to Build Some. And in today's video, what I want to talk about is excavations and how we make them safe for us to enter them. So here in Australia, the deepest trench that we can get into to do any work is 1.5 metres deep. And on the average person, who's about 1.8 metres tall, it comes up to about there. Now, one of the reasons for that is there's a thing called compressive asphyxiation, where if you get too much weight on your chest, you can basically suffocate. So if you were to get a trench collapse, then with the 1.5 metre depth, you're not going to get too much material up around your chest. And this, of course, assumes that you're standing up at the time that the trench collapses. But anyway, that's the depth, 1.5 metres. So what happens if you are required to get into a trench that's deeper than 1.5 metres? What can we do? Well, there's a couple of different methods we can use. The first one is called benching. And basically what it is stepping the trench in maximum 1.5 metre steps and making sure that this side is back far enough that if it was to collapse, it wouldn't subsequently fall into the trench, it would stay on this step. So that's called benching, or some people call it stepping, but it's commonly referred to as benching. Problem with this, as you can see, a lot of excavation required, a lot of material needs to be removed just to get a fairly small trench, so you know, not very commonly used. The other method is called battering. Right, again, a lot of excavation. This angle that these are cut at should be the angle of repose, and I have another video explaining what that means. But again, lots of excavation, so not too commonly used. And of course, there's a combination of the two. So we've got a bench here, and then a batter on the side. Again, angle of repose, so not a lot of over excavation, but still a lot of excavation for a fairly small trench. But these are possible methods. Okay, if you've got all the time in the world to dig the hole, then yeah, no problems. The other way we can do it is we can use some shoring systems, and the most common you may see on big roadwork sites are shoring boxes. So these are just preformed boxes that have jacks basically in between them. They get dropped into the trench with an excavator, and you can jack them apart or pin them apart so that they hold the side of the trench up. And you've got a couple of choices. You can either drag them along the trench as you need them, so you're always working in between the shoring box, or of course you could put a whole heap in, but you know, depending on your costs, you know, you may not want to hire a heap, you may just want to have the one. The other method, or another method, these are not the only methods, but is what they call sheet piling, and in particularly in very unstable soil, this is a common method where the shoring is put in first and then the excavation is done later. So it's they use sheets, normally 600 or 900 mil wide, fairly thick steel, up to a couple of mil thick, and these are clipped together to form walls to form the trench, and then they're actually driven into the ground on both sides, driven all the way in, and then you can excavate in between the two sides. Obviously they're driven further into the ground than the actual depth of the trench, so that they're holding here, and then once they're dug, you need to put some extra support in the top to stop the top pushing over. But once that's done, then obviously you can get into the trench and work fairly safely in there without the trench caving in on you. Alright, so there's the three methods of working safely in a trench: benching, battering, and a combination of those, and shoring. And as I said, there's heaps of different methods of shoring, and the ones I've shown you are just a couple of common methods that I'm aware of.